See you all. Those who missed the chance will wait for the next time. This is our third session. In this session, we are going to learn about globe, latitudes and longitudes. Today, let's start the first part of this lesson, latitudes. In the first session of geography, we learn about the Earth in the solar system. Today, we will start with the second chapter in geography, globe, latitudes and longitudes. Our planet Earth is not a sphere. It is slightly flattened at the north and the south poles and bulged in the middle. The shape of the Earth is called geoid. Globes may be varying size and types, big ones and small pocket globes. The globe is not fixed, it can be rotated. On the globe, countries, continents and oceans are shown in their correct size. But it is very difficult to describe the location of a point on a sphere like the Earth. So we need certain points of reference and lines to find out the location of the places. A needle is fixed through the globe in a tilt manner, which is called its axis. Two points on the globe through which the needle passes are two poles, the North Pole and the South Pole. The globe can be moved around its needle, west to east. But real Earth has no such needle. It moves around its axis, which is an imaginary line. Another imaginary line that divides it into two equal parts, known as equator. The northern half of the Earth is known as northern hemisphere, and the southern half is known as southern hemisphere. They are both equal halves. Therefore, equator is an imaginary circular line and is very important reference point to locate places on the Earth. All parallel circles from the east to west are parallels of latitudes. These are measured in degrees. The equator represents 0 degree latitude. The distance from the equator to either of the poles is 1/4 of a circle round the Earth. It will be measured 1/4 of 360 degree, that is 90 degree. 90 degree north latitude marks the North Pole and 90 degree south latitude marks the South Pole. All parallels north of the equator are called north latitudes. Similarly, all parallels south of the equator are called south latitudes. So the value of each latitude is followed by the word north and south, or by using the letters N or S. Important parallels of latitudes. Beside the equator, the North Pole and the South Pole, there are 4 important parallels of latitudes. They are: first, the Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north. Second, the Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degree south. Third, Arctic Circle at 66.5 degree north. And the fourth one, Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degree south. Points of the Earth. The midday sun is exactly overhead at least once a year on all latitudes in between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Thus, these areas receive the maximum heat of the sun is called the torrid zone. The midday sun never shines overhead on any latitudes beyond the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. the angle of sun's rays goes on decreasing towards the poles. As such areas bounded by Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle, and the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle have moderate temperatures. Therefore, these areas are called temperate zone. Areas lying between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere are very cold, because here the sun does not rise much above the horizon. Therefore, its rays are always slanting and provides less heat. So these are called freeze zone or frigid zone. In the next section, we will study about the meridians of longitude. Let's recall what we learned. Globe is a true model of the Earth. The Earth shape is known as geoid. Axis is an imaginary line that passes through the center of the Earth by connecting north and south poles. We need certain points of reference and lines to find out the location of places. Equator is an imaginary line that divides the Earth into two equal parts, such as the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. All parallel circles from the equator up to the poles are called parallels of latitudes. The equator represents the 0° latitude. The heat source. Based on the heat received from the sun, the Earth is divided into three heat zones. They are the torrid zone, the temperate zone, and the frigid zone. I hope all of you understood the lesson clearly. Now, take a notebook and write it down. Answer the following questions. First one, what is the true shape of the Earth? Answer, geoid. Second question, what is a globe? Answer, first point, globe is a true model of the Earth. Second point, on the globe, countries, continents and oceans are shown in the correct size. What are the three heat zones of the Earth? Answer, based on the heat received from the sun, the Earth is divided into three heat zones. They are torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. What are parallels of latitude? Answer, 5 points are there. First point, all parallel circles from the equator up to the poles are called parallels of latitudes. Second point, latitudes are measured in degrees. Third point, the equator represents the 0° latitude. Fourth point, all parallels north of the equator are called north latitudes and south of the equator are called south latitudes. Last point, as we move away from the equator, the size of the parallels of latitude decreases. Define the following. A. Axis. The axis is an imaginary line which passes through the center of the Earth by connecting the North Pole and the South Pole. B. Equator. Equator is an imaginary line running on the globe which divides the Earth into two equal parts, such as the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. Worksheet. Draw a diagram showing the important parallels of latitudes and heat zones. You will get the picture from the textbook, page number 11, figure 2.3. Use different colors for each zone. Thank you, children.